Warm wishes to one and all. Myself, my name is Sai Kiran. Today's our topic is trigonometric identities. Before going to this one, we need to discuss about right angle triangle. When you take a right angle triangle, okay, one of the angle is 90 degrees. I will fix one more angle here, angle theta. Whenever we are taking these two angles, we can give the names of a right angle triangle. Then this is hypotenuse. This will become opposite. And this will become adjacent. Whenever it is a right angle triangle, we can apply Pythagoras theorem. What is Pythagoras theorem is, directly I am writing hypotenuse square. Hypotenuse square is equal to side square. What is another side means opposite square plus another side is adjacent square. Okay. Then you divide the both sides with hypotenuse square. Then what is happened? Then you divide the both sides with hypotenuse square. Hypotenuse square by hypotenuse square is equal to here opposite square plus adjacent square whole by hypotenuse square. When you divide these two, we are getting 1. Okay, we can rewrite as here we can simplify with individually, and what we are getting, opposite square by hypotenuse square plus adjacent square by hypotenuse square is equal to 1. When you rewrite as this one simplification form, opposite by hypotenuse square is equal to, sorry, plus adjacent by hypotenuse square is equal to 1. When you observe this one, it is one other trigonometric ratio, and this is also another trigonometric ratio. That means what you can write, opposite by hypotenuse is nothing but sine square. It is there, sine square with respect to angle theta. That means sine square theta. Here it is nothing but adjacent by hypotenuse is nothing but cos theta. That is cos square theta is equal to 1. Okay, here it is one other trigonometric identity. Okay, what is one other trigonometric identity? Sine square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. In the place of theta, we can take any angle, it is always 1. In the same way, by using this first trigonometric identity, we can rewrite second and third also. Just here once of the, when you divide both sides with cos square theta, when you divide both sides with cos square theta, can I write individually directly? Sine square theta by cos square theta plus cos square theta by cos square theta is equal to 1 by cos square theta. When you cancel these two, then when you simplify this one, sin square theta by cos square theta is tan square theta plus cos square theta by cos square theta 1. 1 by cos square theta means we know secant square theta. Secant square theta. Then tan square theta will send to that side, means then what you are getting? Secant square theta. Tan square theta will go to that side, means minus tan square theta is equal to 1. Okay, secant square theta minus tan square theta is equal to 1. Here, when you take the any angle here, it is not satisfied. Why? Because once of the, if you take the angle at 90, if you take angle at 90, secant square 90 minus tan square 90. Secant 90 value is not defined. Tan 90 value is not defined. Tan square, secant square 90 means not defined square, not defined only. Here, not defined minus not defined means not defined only. That means always it is not always 1. When it is not always 1 means whenever we are taking the odd multiple of 90, whenever we are taking the odd multiple of 90, it is not defined. Whenever except odd multiple of 90, it is always 1. That means it is one other trigonometric identity. It is when it is possible means for all theta is not belongs to odd multiple of 90. Odd multiple of 90 means 2n plus 1 into pi by 2. 2n plus 1 into pi by 2. Not odd multiple of 90. Whenever we are taking odd multiple of 90, it is not correct. It is not always 1. Understood? Okay, here for the first identity, for any angle, it is always 1 only. For the second identity, here what we can say, theta is not belongs to odd multiple of 90. Okay, then in the same way, okay, when you divide with the first identity by sine square theta, that means again first identity we are taking, this is second identity, first identity we are taking, divide with the sine square theta, then what you are getting? Sine square theta by sine square theta plus cos square theta by sine square theta is equal to 1 by sine square theta. When you simplify this one, then what you are getting? 1 plus cot square theta. Here 1 by sin square theta means cosecant square theta. Cosecant square theta. When your cot square theta will send to that side, means that what we are getting? Cosecant square theta minus cot square theta is equal to 1. Okay, here also this is not always 1. Why? Because when you take the theta is a integral multiple of 180. Same, it is not defined. That means it is theta is belongs not belongs to n pi. N pi. For all theta is not belongs to n pi, cosecant square theta minus cot square theta is equal to 1. That means whenever theta is not belongs to n pi, it is always 1. Wherever theta is a integral multiple of pi, then it is not defined. And next, by using trigonometric identities, we can rewrite as some more formulas. But the first identity. What is first identity? Sin square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. By using this identity, we can write some more formulas. What does that mean? This here one to the I want sin square theta. That means plus cos square theta will send to that side. Then what is happening? Sin square theta is equal to 1 minus cos square theta. In the same way, we want sin theta. What is sin theta means? Square will send to that side means square root. Square root of 1 minus cos square theta. In the similarly, we can rewrite. We want cos square theta. That means sin square theta will send to that side. Plus sin square theta will send to that side means then what you are getting? Cos square theta is equal to 1 minus sin square theta. In the same way, cos theta is equal to what we can write? 1 square is square root of 1 minus sin square theta. That means by using the first identity, what we can write? Sin square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. Then sin square theta is equal to 1 minus cos square theta. In the same way, cos square theta is equal to 1 minus sin square theta. Sin theta is equal to square root of 1 minus cos square theta. Cos theta is equal to square root of 1 minus sin square theta. In the same way, by using second identity, what is second identity? Secant square theta minus tan square theta is equal to 1. By using this one, just here once you can observe, okay, we want secant square theta. Secant square theta means secant square theta minus tan square theta will send to that side means plus only, na? That means 1 plus tan square theta. 1 plus tan square theta. Secant square theta is equal to what we can write? 1 plus tan square theta. In the same way, just here once observe, I want tan square theta. Okay, when you want here tan square theta means we are getting minus tan square theta. I want tan square theta. Plus tan square theta means tan square theta. Tan square theta, that means plus 1 will send to this side. That means tan square theta is equal to what we are getting? Okay, plus 1 will send to that side means secant square theta minus 1. That means secant square theta minus 1. In the same way, we want secant theta. Secant theta means what we can get? Square will send to that side means square root. Square root of 1 plus tan square theta. The same way, we want tan theta. Tan theta means what we can write? Square root of secant square theta minus 1. In the same way, by using this identity, we can write one more formula. One more formula, what does that mean? So just here once of the secant square theta minus tan square theta is equal to 1. Just here once of the, when you observe these two, secant square theta minus tan square theta, this is looking like a square minus b square. A square minus b square means what you can write? A plus b into a minus b. A plus b means secant theta plus tan theta into secant theta minus tan theta is equal to 1. In the same way, we want product of these two numbers is equal to 1. Product of these two numbers is equal to 1. That is nothing but a into b is equal to 1. Then a is equal to, okay, b will send to that side. Means, okay, product, whenever it is in multiplication, it will send to that side division. That means in the same way, secant theta plus tan theta is equal to what we can write? 1 by secant theta minus tan theta. In the same way, secant theta minus tan theta we want. Secant theta minus tan theta is equal to this one will send to that side. Mean what you are getting? Secant theta minus tan theta is equal to what we can write? 1 by secant theta plus tan theta. Okay. In the same way, by using third identity also we can write three like that, like this. Okay, what does that means? Just simply we can remember. What is third identity? Just here once of the secant square theta minus cot square theta is equal to 1. We want only cosecant square theta. Cot square theta will send to that side. Then what we are getting? Cosecant square theta is equal to cot square will send to that side means 1 plus cot square theta. We want cosecant square, cosecant theta. Okay, that means cosecant theta is equal to square will send to that side means square root of 1 plus cot square theta. In the same way, we want cot square theta. Here we want cot square theta means minus cot square theta we get. That means we want cot square theta. Cot square theta we want means plus 1 will send to this side means minus. Then cot square theta is equal to what we are getting? Cosecant square theta minus 1. In the same way, cot theta is equal to what we can get? Cot theta is equal to square root of cosecant square theta minus 1. In the same way, just this identity when you observe this one, cosecant square theta minus cot square theta is equal to 1. It is looking like again a square minus b square. A square minus b square means what we can write? A plus b into a minus b. That means cosecant theta plus cot theta into cosecant theta minus cot theta is equal to 1. Okay, by using same, in the same way before identity, what we are writing? Cosecant theta plus tan theta, sorry, cot theta is equal to, then this one will send to that side means division. That means cosecant theta plus cot theta is equal to 1 by cosecant theta minus cot theta. In the same way, we want cosecant theta minus cot theta. Cosecant theta minus cot theta. Cot theta is equal to what will be? 1 by cosecant theta plus cot theta. Example, okay. Write all the trigonometric ratios in terms of secant theta. By using trigonometric identities, we can convert into all the trigonometric ratios secant theta, or we can use another method also, we can convert in terms of secant theta. Okay, by using trigonometric identities, I'll say. Okay, for example, I'll take a sine theta. Sine theta in terms of secant theta we want by using trigonometric identities. Okay, by trigonometric identity, sine theta is equal to what we can write? Square root of 1 minus cos square theta we can write. Okay, in the same way here, what is cos square theta means? Okay, reciprocal of secant we can write. Reciprocal of secant we can write means 1 minus here, it is nothing but 1 by secant square theta. When you simplify this one, what you are getting? Secant square theta minus 1 by secant square theta. When you simplify again, rewrite as secant square theta minus 1 by here square root of secant square theta means secant theta. Okay, sine theta in terms of secant theta means we can write square root of secant square theta minus 1 by secant theta. Okay, by using trigonometric identities, we can. Okay, same question we can do in another manner. Okay, how we can do means trigonometric ratios in terms of secant theta. Okay, in terms of what trigonometric ratio they are given, we need to observe. In terms of secant, let it be secant theta is equal to some k. Okay. K we can written as k by 1 we can write na. Okay, what is trigonometric ratio of secant theta means hypotenuse by adjacent. When you observe the right angle triangle, when you take a right angle triangle, here it is right angle, then it will become hypotenuse. When you take this is some angle theta, this will become opposite, this will become adjacent. Okay, here observe this one, hypotenuse by adjacent. Hypotenuse by adjacent means hypotenuse is k, adjacent is 1. Okay, it is multiple of k and it is multiple of 1 only, nothing but hypotenuse is k and adjacent is 1. We want to find opposite side. How we can find opposite side means by using Pythagoras theorem we can find opposite side. By Pythagoras theorem can I write directly hypotenuse square is equal to side square opposite square plus adjacent square. Okay, that means just here one of the k square is equal to opposite square plus 1 square. Okay, this 1 square become 1 only, plus 1 will send to this side means minus 1. Then opposite square is equal to what we are getting? K square minus 1. We want opposite only. Opposite is equal to square will send to that side means square root of k square minus 1. Then opposite what we are getting? Square root of k square minus 1. In the same way, just here once we want to find other trigonometric ratios. We want to find sine theta. What is sine? Means opposite by hypotenuse. What is opposite here? Opposite is square root of k square minus 1 by hypotenuse is k. Okay, in generally starting, what is k means? Secant theta we are ready. That means what you can write? Square root of secant square theta minus 1 by secant theta. That means just here once the sine theta in terms of secant means we are getting this one. Okay, in the same way we want cos theta. What is cos theta means? Adjacent by hypotenuse. What is adjacent here? Okay, 1 by hypotenuse is k. That is nothing but 1 by secant theta. In the same way, we want tan theta. What is tan theta means? Opposite by hypotenuse. Opposite by adjacent. Opposite by adjacent means opposite is square root of k square minus 1 by 1. Square root of k square minus 1 by 1 means what is k means? Square root of secant square theta minus 1. The same way, cot theta. What is cot theta means? Adjacent by opposite. Adjacent by opposite means 1 by square root of k square minus 1. That means nothing but 1 by square root of secant square theta minus 1. The same way, cosecant theta. Cosecant theta. What is cosecant theta means? Hypotenuse by R, nothing but reciprocal of sine only. What is reciprocal of sine we are getting? Okay. Secant theta by square root of secant square theta minus 1. Thank you.